I just performed a ritual with my mom. The moment has passed, but I'll record it in these pages for you for the future. I never knew when my mom would share a memory of Dad while cooking, on a walk, with no warning. It knocked the wind out of me. Rituals take this grief and give it a shape and a story. Filling in this journal is a ritual too, but for a loss that hasn't hit us yet. I've brought tools to record the sights and sounds of this season. I'll start by recording the only place I've ever known. Public sleep music is a tradition of ours here. When the music ends, the village will begin to wake up. We have plenty of fresh water here. I wonder if it's more scarce in the outside world. Last night there was a goodbye party here in the plaza. Everyone was so afraid for me. To understand that fear, to understand where I grew up, you have to know the man standing watch over the plaza, Dr. Fumio. This is Dr. Fumio and his son. The statue isn't as old as it looks. The artist wore it down to give it a feeling of ancientness and the authority that comes with it. Dr. Fumio and his son founded Caro back in 776. They live on through our traditions. There are three murals celebrating Dr. Fumio's work. These birds migrate, but we don't know where they come from or where they're going. A wish fell off the tree. I'm not supposed to read them, but it might be good for you to have an example of one. I can go against tradition a little for posterity, we learn to grow cures for maladies from the outside world, even though they seem to be long gone. It's just tradition. Remembering everything must be painful. Dr. Fumio brought peace to so many people here. A village that was created as a place to heal. Is that where my instinct to try to help comes from? It's so strange to imagine I'll be shaped by places and people I haven't met yet. So strange to imagine that I might feel at home somewhere else. Kate loves fish, even though nobody here has ever seen one. I wish I could tell you more about this poster, but I never thought to ask what it means. Now we'll both never know what it means. Oh well. The elder sought out Dr. Fumio to cure her mother, who was suffering from time misperception. Last night, my friends wrote down their hopes for my trip and tied them to the branches of this tree. Smells like an old man's toes dipped in cinnamon. I had to drink this gross potion last night. Like my pendant, it's supposed to protect my brain. This is a healing instrument created by Dr. Fumio. It draws on the pure mountain air. Pate's little daydream of leaving this place, of seeing something weird. Dr. Fumio said the dream sickness was caused by something very powerful. He wasn't able to cure it. Dr. Fumio was an important person, but we also just have a need to put a human face on events that are beyond our control. He may have felt just as scared and helpless as everyone else. This is the cafe where my dad used to read his poems. He wrote one for me. Maybe he wrote it for you too. I go fishing here with my best friend, Pate, even though there's nothing to catch. We both appreciate the silence. Caro Village was founded during the modernity. Much later, Dr. Fumio arrived and remade it in his image. I've always wondered what's on the other side of this gate. Today, I'll find out. This flower means you're in my thoughts. The morning after the search was called off for Dad, our doorstep was covered in them. Drip, just as slow, reliable, and oddly satisfying as life itself in this little village.
Is it recording?
Yes.
Okay. How to leave home for my daughter. Find a sacred square of earth. Lay down so you have the dirt at your back. Close your eyes. Everything. Do you see for yourself? You see for the dead, for the unborn. Do you listen for yourself? You listen for the dead, for the unborn. Your ancestors are in that dirt. All the living and all the dead are holding you up. Now, stand. They're still there, aren't they? It's time to move, to entangle yourself everywhere with everyone. So the next time you lay down in the dirt, you will have so much more to tell them.
These bikes were used by messengers a long, long time ago. Tate fixed up three bikes instead of one. The ruins in the distance were used to make us afraid of the outside world. Dangerous and impossible to reach, they said. I hold a photograph of everyone I've ever known. I hold it tight.